Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Morning Tales for May 4, 2019. As you remember in the previous video, I asked you a question regarding the RBI ombudsman offices in the whole country, and that too according to the annual report for banking ombudsman scheme. So according to that, there are a total of 21 offices after one office which was inaugurated last year in Mumbai. Now coming to the annual report for banking ombudsman scheme, as it is mentioned over here, it's for the financial year 2017-18. That means the financial year for RBI, which starts from July 1st, 2017 to June 30, 2018. So for this duration, this annual report for banking ombudsman scheme has been prepared. Now, rather than discussing about the number of complaints or the redressal, we'll be discussing more about the or we'll be focusing on the banking ombudsman scheme. So starting with the what of the banking ombudsman scheme, what is the banking ombudsman scheme, when was it launched and what is the purpose of this scheme? So it was implemented by RBI, so it's kind of a forum where the bank customers can go up to RBI for resolution of complaints related to the services which are rendered by the banks. So whenever the grievances are not redressed at the bank level, then the grievance person can go up to RBI for the resolution. Another thing is introduced under the section 35A of the Banking Regulation Act 1949. And who is the person who has been appointed for this banking ombudsman scheme? So the person is known as banking ombudsman. So banking ombudsman is a senior official who has been appointed by the Reserve Bank of India itself to redress the customer complaints. So this is the basic structure of the banking ombudsman scheme, which came effect from 1995. Moving on to the annual report for the Banking Ombudsman Scheme 2017-2018. So what were the regulatory changes which were brought in this duration of July 2017 to June 2018? So which are the banks which are covered under the Banking Ombudsman Scheme? So Scheduled Commercial Bank, Primary Urban Cooperative Banks, Regional Rural Banks and the Small Finance Banks and Payment Bank. These all are covered under the BO Scheme. Another thing was the compensation or the award was increased from 1 million to 2 million. That means from 10 lakh to 20 lakh. Now the maximum amount which can be rewarded under this banking ombudsman scheme is 20 lakh rupees. Another very, very important feature was that introduced for the customers of deposit taking NBFC, which was a very major step or which was a very important step taken by the RBI. Now, what is the procedure for approaching the banking ombudsman? So if the person is not satisfied with the bank or the reply is not received within 30 days regarding that application from the bank, then the person can visit the or can file with the RBI. After approaching the banking ombudsman of RBI, another 30 days duration is given. And after that, if the person is not even satisfied with the banking ombudsman, he or she can visit the appellate tribunal, which is actually the powers of this appellate tribunal is vested with the deputy governor of RBI. So this process needs to be followed for approaching the banking ombudsman. Now coming back to the current affairs for the May 4, 2019, who has been conferred with the France highest civil and honor for contribution towards India's France Space Cooperation. So the former ISRO chairman A.S. Kiran Kumar has been honored with this France highest civilian honor, and that too for contributing towards the India's France Space Corporation. The names mentioned over here are the former ISRO chairman. K. Sivan is the current chairman of ISRO. And what is the name of the highest civilian honor of France? So it is National Order of Legion of Honor. It has been conferred upon A.S. Kiran Kumar. Moving on to the next question, as per ICC test team ranking for men's team released recently, which team has secured the first position? Mind it, we are talking about the test team. So this is the test ranking, this is ODI ranking, and this is T20 international. So under the test team ranking, India is at the first position, New Zealand second, and South Africa third position. ODI ranking, England is at the first position, India at the second, and South Africa at the third. For T20 International, Pakistan is at the first position, followed by South Africa and England, but India is at the fifth position. Also, previous ranking revealed the same result for India and England in the Test and ODI respectively. So, India and England have actually maintained their position or they have continued to top in their rankings for Test and ODI respectively. Now, as per the ICC test team ranking for men's team, the India is at the first position. Moving on to the next question, who is the author of the book Politics of Jugaad, the Coalition Handbook? So, India's renowned journalist Sabha Naqvi, she has authored this book, Politics of Jugaad, the Coalition Handbook, which actually examines the possibility of coalition government after the 2019 Lok Sabha election. Therefore, this book becomes important. The 2019 Lok Sabha election coalition, the book is revolving around this coalition. If you talk about some other books of Sabha Naqvi, so some other names are The Good Faith. Another one is The Capital Conquest, Shades of Saffron. So these are some of the very famous books of Sabha Naqvi. Name any book which has been written by Shashi Tharoor. Please mention your answer in the comment section. What is the name of the book which has been written by Shashi Tharoor? Any name would be fine. The next is the first country in the world to declare an environment and climate emergency. So this is for the first time that the government of United Kingdom, that is UK, has declared the environment and climate emergency. So this means that they have set a net zero target of no greenhouse gas emissions by 2050. So this is what it means by the environment and climate emergency, which has been declared for the first time by United Kingdom, which has been first time declared by any country in the world. Very, very important question. Environment related questions are usually asked in the examination and in fact in the UGC exam as well. So there's a question for you. Now, why I am framing question and asking you in the comment section so that you can, while learning the current affairs, you can in fact retain the static as well. So where is Mulshi Dam located? So Mulshi Dam, for that I'll be giving you hint over here. So these are the name of the dams which are located in this state. So a dam which is located in this state is Totladog Dam. Another dam which is located in a very, very famous dam of this state is Koyna Dam. Now you might have guessed the answer. So even if you have not guessed the answer till now, another dam, now it becomes very easy for you to guess the answer. So Bheem Dam is also located in the state in which this Mulshi Dam is located. So along with the Mulshi Dam, these three dams are also located. So mention your answer in the comment section. Just make it a guess as well that where is this Mulshi Dam located. Thank you so much for watching the video. If you have learned anything, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and in fact press the bell icon so that you can get the notification as and when the video is posted. You can also visit the website www.anujjindal.in, where you can read the current affairs and in fact get the PDF as well. The links are already available in the description. Thank you so much for watching the video.